you've heard the work of film composers. Whether it be John Williams' timeless theme for Star Wars, Hans Zimmer's rousing scores for the Dark Knight trilogy, or Hildur Guðnadóttir's haunting soundscape for Joker. All these works have one thing in common. They heighten the experience of watching the film. I wrote this to hopefully help people appreciate the music in their favorite movies, as well as to teach them about the incredible work that goes into crafting a score. Scoring a film is done in a few steps. First is spotting, which is when the composer and director watch the film and decide what music goes where and what style and thematic material are needed for the film. Second is the composing process, where the composer actually writes the music. Depending on the score, the next step is orchestrating and recording, where the composer will work with an orchestrator to create parts for musicians to read and then record the musicians playing the score. Finally is delivery, where the finalized music is sent to the film editors to be placed in the film. In order to write music for a film, you need to be able to, first, actually write good music, and second, have an understanding of the story of the film. The best film scores tell the story in a meaningful way when the composer has worked closely with the director. There are a few tools that most composers use to write music. Most modern composers use a computer to write their music, creating digital mockups using sample libraries, which are recordings of real instruments that have been programmed to be played in real time. The benefit of using these mockups is that the director and editors know exactly what the final product is going to sound like. Some older composers, like John Williams, write their music with pencil and paper, the old-fashioned way, although this has become increasingly less common as the digital age has set in. This has made the process much faster, as a typical film score will take around 3 weeks to 4 months to write. It all starts with the spotting session. The director and composer will sit down and watch the movie from start to finish, taking note of where the music should start and stop, and what kind of music should go in which scene. After this, the task of actually writing the music begins. The film will be split up into sections called cues, which are the places where the music should come in. These cues are then organized into reels, which are sections of the film that are 20 minutes long. This comes from the days when films were actually shot on film, and one reel of film could hold about 20 minutes of footage. The composer will take notes about the music from the spotting session and write each cue accordingly. The composer will send the finished cue to the director, who will make notes on what they want changed. The composer will edit the cue accordingly, and this will go back and forth until the director is happy. Once the cue's finished, it's sent to an orchestrator, who turns the computer file into sheet music that the musicians can read. When all the cues are done and orchestrated, they are sent to a music library, who prints out all the parts for the musicians. The orchestra contractor hires the musicians and books the studio. Once the score is recorded, it's sent to a mixing engineer, who makes it sound clean and tidy. When the mix is finished, the music is sent off to the editors, who put it in the movie. Perhaps the hardest part of writing a film score is telling the story of the film. Most films, especially modern ones, will opt to simply have music that matches the emotion of the scene and nothing else. However, that can lead to scores sounding very similar and, in my opinion, boring. The great composers such as John Williams and Hans Zimmer know that the story is the most important aspect of a movie.
I didn't want to be in a band, I wanted to tell stories. And that's what film allows you to do. You know, I'm a storyteller, really.
They also know that the best way of telling a film story is through the use of leitmotifs, or themes, which are recurring musical pieces that represent an element of the story. For example, in Star Wars, Darth Vader's theme is as follows.
I am your father.
Whenever Darth Vader enters, is talked about, or has something to do with what's happening in the story, Williams plays this leitmotif. Leitmotifs are so powerful because they can be incredibly versatile and even foreshadow aspects of the story that the audience knows nothing about yet. For example, Anakin's theme shares its musical DNA with Vader's theme.
Everybody sort of realizes that the Imperial March is hidden inside Anakin's theme somewhere, but I don't think people realize just how much it's in there. It's in there from the opening bars. So you have these chords. But if I changed all that to just minor, you start to recognize this is the Imperial March chords.
Leitmotifs do not have to be melodic, though. For example, in Hans Zimmer's score for The Dark Knight, the Joker's leitmotif is a distorted rising figure, which bears some similar characteristics to Batman's leitmotif.
You have nothing! Nothing to threaten me with! Nothing to do with all your strength!
Don't worry! I'm gonna tell you where they are.
Both of them. And that's the point.
Batman's leitmotif is a short two-note rising figure from D to F, mostly played in the brass. It is usually played with a very pronounced swell in volume, which is similar to the Joker's motif. This is to show that Batman and the Joker are two sides of the same coin.
I don't want to kill you. What would I do without you? Go back to ripping off mob dealers? No, you. You complete me.
You're garbage. You kills for money.
Don't talk like one of them. You're not. Even if you'd like to be. To them, you're just a freak. Like me.
Leitmotifs are a very powerful and common way to tell a musical story, but only the best composers have a true grasp of handling them in complex ways. Film scores are perhaps the most financially viable way for a composer to make a living, and as such are very important to study as an art form. I hope that this video has deepened your appreciation for this art form and will cause you to think more about the music in your favorite films.